seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 months. That's what the doctor told us. 6 months. Maybe a few more.
More. I want more. I can't stop. Once I start, I can't stop.
Stop. Stop. Stop. I want to scream it as loud as I can, but I can't. I'm too scared.
Scared every day. Scared every minute of every day. Scared to death.
Death comes to us all. Everyone dies. There's no control over whether you will or you won't. You will.
Willow, she said. Willow, your father and I just don't love each other anymore. Do you understand?
Understand? I don't expect you to understand. I don't understand. I just want to stop the
pain, stress, fear, loneliness. She washes it all away. She's beautiful, tempting, and deadly. And once she has you, she will not let go.
Let go, Eli! Let go!
One,
two,
Eli!
Hello?
Three, four,
Eli!
Five,
hello?
Six, seven,
Eli!
Hello?
Eight, nine,
are you alright?
Ten!
Are you alright?
Germs. I don't like to be touched.
Neither do I.
I'm not much of a fan either.
I'm not a real fan of germs.
needs to really think hard about where they were before we all ended up here.
For every evil under sun, there is a remedy, or there is none. If there is one, seek till you find it. If there is none, never mind it.
Twisted.
Eli!
I was in my locker.
Getting your pocket protector.
I remember that it was after school.
I said I was in my locker, not at my locker.
In your locker?
It's not funny.
Yeah, it is.
Knock it off, Cyrus. Arnold, it might be embarrassing, but it's important that we know the last thing you remember.
Some guys from the football team grabbed me, held me upside down, and shoved me in the locker. It was dark, and I couldn't breathe.
Is that everything?
I'm claustrophobic. I was crying.
Loser.
Shut up!
Oh, shut up! Oh, you're a tough girl now, aren't you? Not quite so tough with a boyfriend slapping you around.
And lay off!
Oh, you're gonna be the knight in shining armor, Eli.
Right now, you need to shut up and sit down.
You're gonna make me?
If I have to.
Cyrus! Sit down!
Listen to your sister, Cyrus. You aren't helping. Tabitha, where were you?
I was just hanging out with Jimmy.
That's all?
That's all.
Are you sure?
It was an accident. It was an accident.
I was at chemotherapy. You didn't think this was a fashion statement, did you?
Yeah, that's what I was doing too. Chemotherapy.
I hardly call what you were doing therapy.
A little time with Dr. Philgood always does the trick. Right, little Alice P. Toklas?
Don't think so.
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. The little brownie goes in, but...
Not helping.
Just because I was in the bathroom doesn't mean I was vomiting.
I was in the bathroom too. Not the same bathroom. And I wasn't vomiting. I was washing my hands 10 times.
I was packing up for a weekend at my dad's. Or was it my mom's?
I was writing a note.
A note to who?
I don't know. To everyone.
About?
I don't know, Eli. What about you? Where were you? What were you doing?
Eli!
We're not talking about me right now.
Eli!
Well, maybe we should. Where were you?
I was at the river, all right? Never mind. I'm trying to figure out what got us here.
Why?
So I can get us out.
Maybe some of us don't want to get out.
Why would you want to stay?
Eli!
Because it's safe.
You'd rather be trapped and safe than to fight your way to freedom?
Some days, yes. And today's a someday.
I was in my room. There's this little glass doll I have sitting on my dresser. It was perfect and beautiful. I had it for years. I got it when I was 5. One of those cheesy tour shops along the highway. I think it was called Uncle Ukulele's Treasure Palace or something like that. I would always stare at her before I went to sleep at how perfect her skin was and how beautiful her eyes were. She seemed to have some fabulous dreams in behind those eyes. One day, a friend came over. At least I thought he was a friend, but he wasn't. While he was there, the glass doll fell to the floor and broke. I glued her back together the best that I could, and I put her back on my dresser. She still has some cracks and bruises. But I still see some dreams in her eyes.
Logically, I know that counting to 10 won't stop me from getting sick. Or getting into a car accident. Or suddenly losing my vision. But how do I know that it won't help? The one time I don't do it could be the one time I needed to do it. and that could mean catastrophe. And washing my hands is just good hygiene. It has nothing to do with the voice in my head. Germs are bad and dirty. It can cause illness, disease, and pink eye, which could possibly cause blindness. And even if I don't catch anything because I don't wash my hands, I could pass on illness, disease, or pink eye, and I don't think I could live with myself if I ever cause someone to go blind. So I have to wash my hands 10 times, always 10 times.
Acute myeloid leukemia. That's what the doctor said. I'm young, but I knew when he said acute, he wasn't talking about my sweater. It sucked before I knew I had cancer. I was tired all the time, and I couldn't breathe. But once I got the diagnosis, it sucked even more. Now, not only am I tired all the time, and out of breath, I get to add vomiting and hair loss to the list. I remember when I was 15, I couldn't wait to get my license. 6 months felt like forever. Now 6 months seems like a blink.
Here's the thing. I know I'm not perfect. I know I can never be perfect. But when you look around, perfection is everywhere. I'm not fat. I know I'm not fat. I'm just big boned. But you don't see big boned girls selling you jeans. Heck, big boned girls don't even sell you cat food. So, what's a big boned girl to do? A big boned girl who likes her food. She learns to adapt and to really chew her food. And pizza is not a friend the second time around. I don't enjoy going to the bathroom after every meal, turning on the water so no one will hear, staring into the toilet trying to psych myself up like I'm responsible for the winning basket at the championship game, kneeling on the cold, hard floor. Why are bathroom floors always so cold? I hate the sounds, I hate the smells, I hate how it feels. It's not easy, but neither is being a big boned girl in a skinny girl world.
He loves me. I know it. He really does love me. And I love him. He needs me. And I don't know what I would do without him. When we first started going out, he was so, so sweet. He would call me every night, and we'd talk until 3 o'clock in the morning. He would always hold my hand when we walked down the hall, and he would never let me go to lunch without him. But lately, he's been a little stressed out, and he's been yelling a lot. And sometimes he forgets that I'm not as strong as his buddies, and he hits me in the arm a little too hard. Today, we got into a pretty big argument, and while it is my fault, I really shouldn't be texting other guys. We've had a few ups and downs, but he really does love me. He just has a funny way of showing.
I just want to know why. Why me? Did I wear a sign the first day of school that said, "Hi, I'm a punching bag"? I've never done anything to anyone. I just want to go about my business. I want to get to my classes without being hit or tripped or sent for a swirly. I want to get my books without being shoved into the locker. I want to get from my locker to the bus without having obscenity shouted at me, and I would just like to once ride the bus without being pelted with bitter garbage! And not being lit on fire would be nice too.
Hi, sweet, sweet hi. Beautiful, tempting, deadly, she's what drives me. The only thing that drives me, pushes me, motivates me, she's all I think of and dream of. That next high, that next escape, nothing else matters, not life, not death, just her. Not do anything to be with her. Lie, cheat, steal, whatever it takes to spend one more second wrapped in her arms. She tried to kill me once. A few more minutes with her would have turned me into venture fertilizer. She left me lying in my own vomit on the floor, convulsing, but still, I can't break her hold on me. And I tried to stay away. Really, I did. She calls to me all day and all night. In my dreams, in my nightmares, begging with me, pleading with me to come back, and I always do. Why stay away? It's so much easier to be with her than to be me.
So, Mom comes home after a girl's night out. The bad boys of Barcelona at the Boom Chicka Boom Room. Aim high, Mom. Anyways, she comes home about 3 a.m. and decides that we need to talk. I have an 800-point chemistry test in the morning, and you want to talk? So, she sits me down and says, things aren't really working out between me and your father. Really? After 18 years, you decide that things aren't working? My parents constantly remind me that the choices I make affect my future. But what about yours, Mom, Dad? How do your choices affect me? Are you guys going to be the ones shuttling from house to house every other weekend? And what about Thanksgiving and Christmas and my birthdays? Who gets me on my birthday? When you find happiness by getting married and having children with some other unsuspecting victim, will you still have time for me? Will you still remember me? Will you still love me? And then Mom tells me Dr. Phil had a show all about children of divorce and how they all turn out fine, but hey Mom, didn't your parents get divorced? Anyways, if Dr. Phil says so, then it must be true. So thank you, Mom, for that 3 a.m. chat. By the way, I got a 50 on my chemistry test.
I have this friend. She's been having a really tough time with school and home and friends. A tough time. She's really trying. Trying to do better in school, trying to deal with the chaos at home, trying to deal with the friends that talk behind her back, but it gets to be too much, and she just wants out. Sometimes I'm not really sure what she means by out. Sometimes I don't think I want to know what she means by out. I really try to be a good friend. Really, I do. I encourage her. I tell her that it'll be all right and that it won't last forever, but sometimes my words just aren't enough. They're hollow and empty. Not enough to stop the loneliness, the darkness, and the cold. It's really, really dark and cold, like a deep, dark hole that keeps filling up with water, and she wants to scream so loud that somebody will hear and come pull me out, but I know no one's there. No one will hear me. No one will say
someone dies. That's what Father Morgan said. Like I didn't already know that. Of course everyone dies. Every thing dies. I learned that when I was 8. I went fishing by myself for the first time at the river, and I caught this little sunfish. It was way too small to keep, and I wasn't really planning on catching or keeping anything. I was so excited. I brought my dad's favorite fishing lure without asking. I was 8. I didn't know what I was doing. I just wanted to be like Dad and go fishing. So I caught this fish and started to take it off the hook like I had done with Dad a million times before. And I couldn't get it out. This stupid thing had swallowed it down past its gills. I tried so hard to get the hook out, but I couldn't. I had a knife, a little dull pocket knife that I always carried in my pocket. So I cut the line and I tried again. But it just wasn't working. All that I could think of was how mad Dad was going to be if I came home and told him that his lure was in the stomach of a bluegill at the bottom of the river. I knew what I had to do. I held the fish down and slowly started to cut its head off. It squirmed and wiggled and did everything it could to save its own life, but I kept gutting. I had to. I had to. Everything dies. But not everything dies in front of you.
Eli, let go! There's this little glass doll I have sitting on my dresser.
Watch, Clee. I know that counting to 10 won't stop me from getting sick.
Acute myeloid leukemia. That's what the doctor said.
Here's the thing. I know I'm not perfect. I know I can never be perfect.
He loves me. I know it. He really does love me.
I just want to know why. Why me?
Hi. Sweet, sweet hi.
So Mom comes home after a girl's night out.
I have this friend. She's been having a really tough time.
Everyone dies. That's what Father Morgan said.
Eli, let's go.
At least I thought he was a friend. It has nothing to do with the voice in my head.
I got to add vomiting and hair loss to the list.
Pizza is not a friend the second time around.
He's been a little stressed out.
I just want to go about my business.
She left me lying my own vomit on the floor.
Who gets me on my birthday?
It's really cold and dark.
I was 8, didn't know what I was doing.
Eli, let's go.
I still see some dreams in her eyes.
I have to wash my hands 10 times, always 10 times.
6 months seems like a blink.
It's not easy being a big bone girl in a skinny girl world.
He loves me, he just has a funny way of showing it.
Not being the fire be nice too.
Why stay away? It's so much easier to be with her than to be me. Everything dies, but not everything dies in front of you.
Eli!
No! We gotta get out of here.
Are we supposed to get out of here?
Yes, we're supposed to get out of here.
Why? I've tried living before and I always come back.
Because this isn't where we're supposed to stay.
What if this is where we're supposed to stay?
It is what it is. Accept it.
Why am I wrong? I've kind of gotten used to it.
So have I. It's starting to feel normal.
I've never been normal. This might be the closest to normal I'll ever get.
Come on, you guys! This is not where we're supposed to stay. You want to be trapped for the rest of your lives.
Eli! I know I can't win this fight. And I'm okay with it. I can live with it. No pun intended.
No. Lila, you can beat this. You can fight this. We're just stuck down in a rabbit hole. We have to find our way out.
Some things are meant to be.
No, Lila! Come on, you guys, we can find our way out. We can be saved.
Not everyone can be saved.
Yes, they can.
No. No, they can't.
Everyone can be saved.
No, not everyone.
Why not? Why would anyone want to stay trapped?
Because it's easier.
It's what I know. Sometimes it's just too hard to fight anymore.
Do you really know how hard the battle is, Eli? Do you?
Yes, I do.
No, I don't think you do. I've been here before. I fought my way up before, and it is the toughest, longest, bloodiest battle you will ever fight, and it will last a lifetime.
It's worth it.
Really? Are you willing to fight that hard to save all of us?
I'm willing to fight with everything I have.
Sometimes that's not enough.
It's
Sometimes not everyone wants to be saved, Elon. You can't save everyone.
Yes, I can. I can and I will. I can save everyone. Really. Really.
Not your sister, Eli. You couldn't save your sister.
No!
Grace?
Yes?
I didn't think I'd recognize you. I was only 8 when...
When I died. Say it, Eli.
When you died. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
For what?
For killing you.
Killing me? You didn't kill me.
Yes, I did. I should have stayed away from the river that day. If I'd known, I would have stayed at home like I was supposed to. I could have.
Would've. It's a tough place to live, Eli.
I shouldn't have been there. I shouldn't have gone in to swim. I could have held on longer. I should have let go of you. I never should have let go.
No, you couldn't have held on longer. You were 8, Eli. A child. And I was your big sister. And I was there to watch out for you.
Died to save me.
Yes. I did.
Why? It was my fault. Why did you have to die?
It wasn't your fault. It just was. It just was. You need to let go again, Eli. You need to let go of the guilt and the pain. You need to fight your way past it. Everyone has their own demons to face. This is yours. This is your battle. And you have a chance to fight. And to win.
Six months. That's what the doctor told us. 6 months. I got 10.
Once she has you, she would not let go. Till death do us part.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear Willow.
Not being lit on fire would be nice too.
He loves me. He just has a funny way of showing it.
It's not easy being a big boned girl in a skinny girl world.
I have this friend. She's been having a really tough time.
Cindy? But she's just a little girl. She shouldn't have anything to fight. That's not fair.